Today I'll be attempting to make a game in 10 minutes, so let's get right into it. I'm gonna click on start, go to scratch, and click on create. Quickly rename it to 10 min game, and then delete the scratch cat. We're gonna quickly draw something up, just like that. A square with some eyes. And a little smile. The smile doesn't look perfect, but it's fine. Now I'm gonna change the size to like 30. Duplicate it and make an enemy. So I'll make the enemy red, flip this and make it mad. And now we need a weapon. So I've had this idea for a while, so I guess I planned ahead. But we need a weapon now, and it's gonna be pretty simple. Just like that, we've got a functioning weapon, and let's just scale it down. 50, yeah, pretty good. And for the weapon to work, we have to like put it over here. Now we're gonna duplicate this and create the bullet, and it's gonna be just red. And let's delete that. Okay, now let's quickly make the player movement. One clicked forever, and then we're gonna change X and change Y. So I've covered the simple movement in a YouTube short. So if you wanna see how to make it, then watch it. Times 5, and then we have two key presses, one key right arrow, one key left arrow, and that's for the X. And for the Y, we can duplicate the same thing but change it to up and down, and just like that we've got a simple player movement. Now we have to bring this weapon to the position of the player, so forever it's gonna go to sprite 1 and I guess, yeah, point towards mouse pointer. Okay, so that's a bit too near, so I'm gonna make it a bit more to the side, and this too. So let's see. Okay, it's perfect. Now we have to code the enemies, and let's just call it enemy. So when clicked, we're going to hide because we do not need the original sprite, and we're gonna get out of forever loop. So every second we can create a clone of myself. And when I start as a clone, just glide 2 seconds to a random position. Oh yeah, and we have to show. Okay, and first let's go to X minus 250. And then Y, pick random 180 to minus 180. And this would just be one for one side of the screen, so I have to duplicate it. Go to X 250, and now let's just code it. So I'm gonna put these two in here. Get out an equals 1, pick random 1 to 2. Oh, okay. And then after this, we're just gonna delete this clone. Okay, it's working pretty good, but I'm just gonna do 1.5 seconds. Still not as fast as I want. I know where some of them are slower, but maybe we can improve this at the end. Now, here, I guess we start with when I start as a clone. I'm gonna point towards the mouse pointer and go to sprite 3. Or you could also just say go to sprite 1, because it's the same. So I'll say go to sprite 1. And these two, I'll bring them to the front. And let's make a score variable. Okay, if forever, if touching the edge or touching an enemy, then delete this clone. And now back to the enemy. So when I just start as a clone, forever, if touching spread 4, then we should just delete this clone and then change score by 1. And we'll set score to 0 at the beginning. Okay, let's see if it works. And it looks like it's not working. Oh, I get why it's not working. I just forgot to start this. So when clicked, we're just gonna hide. And forever, if the mouse is down, then we're gonna create a clone of myself, but there has to be like a slight delay. So we have to wait 0.01 seconds. Or no, 0.1 second. Now let's see what happens. Okay, still not working. Because, oh yeah, I forgot to actually move it. So repeat until touching the edge or touching the enemy. Move 10 steps. And then after this, we'll just delete this clone. Okay, so it's not working exactly as I imagined. Maybe if I point towards sprite 3. So again, no idea why it's not working. I It's like going the opposite direction. What if I point towards the mouse pointer? It should work. But it's not working. See, my mouse pointer is over there, but it's going another way for no reason. Then point in direction 90. And let's see if that makes a difference. Nope. It's still pretty much the same. So what if I point in direction sprite 3? Let's see if that makes a difference. Oh, it's actually working. Let's go. Okay, so as you can see, we have our game here, and I'm just spamming and killing all the enemies, but we can't die. So let's make a quick game over screen. We'll put that in the middle, put this in the middle, and then when clicked forever, actually, when clicked, we're gonna hide, and when I receive message 1, we're gonna show. And let's just do this to detect if it's touching the enemy. Oh, no, that counts. Okay, so timer just went off. Let's just pray that this works. Okay, it's working. Oh, we died. And okay, we died again. And let's go, we've got a working game in under 10 minutes. Of course, it could be better, but as you can see, it was only 10 minutes. So you see, I had to make some adjustments. And if you want a game like this, but like slightly better, then you can just check out my Aspect game. I also have like tutorials on my YouTube for this.